We're going to do a quick recap on the trigonometric function tan and its inverse. Nothing on this slide so far should surprise you. This is pretty standard high school maths. We can rearrange it to isolate tan theta, and we write that in terms of y divided by x. And then we can introduce the inverse tan function. So we can write theta in terms of the inverse tan of y divided by x. The inverse tan function is denoted in many different ways, but most commonly it's written as tan to the power of minus 1, sometimes it's written as a tan, and sometimes it's written as arctan. They're perhaps the most common ways of representing the inverse tangent function. Now let's look at some more complex cases, but we'll start off with the simplest of these cases. And we have a triangle, its height is 1, its width is 2, and the angle marked in the triangle is equal to 0.4636 radians. If I apply the inverse tan function to the ratio 1 over 2, then I get exactly the same value, 0.4636. Let's try for the case where the angle is negative. In this case, the width is 2, but the height is equal to minus 1. I can compute the arctangent of minus 1 divided by 2, and I get the result, which is minus 0.4636, just as I would expect. Now let's consider the case of an angle that's bigger than pi on 2. In this case, the height is 1 and the width is equal to minus 2. In this case, theta is equal to 2.6779 radians. If I compute the arctangent of 1 over minus 2, then I get a result which is minus 0.4636. We see that there is a discrepancy between the actual angle of this line and the angle which is given to us by the arctangent function. And similarly for this case, the width is minus 2, the height is minus 1, and if I compute the arctangent of that, the result I get is 0.4636. The problem in this last case is that negative 1 divided by negative 2 gives a result which is the same as 1 divided by 2. It's a positive number, and that's the same as the example that we did at the beginning up here. The underlying problem here is that the inverse tan function has got a range which only spans from minus pi on 2 to plus pi on 2. To get around the problem, we introduce a new function, and it's commonly called atan2. You'll find a function of this name in the mathematical library of many programming languages, and you'll certainly find it in MATLAB. It takes into account the sine of A and the sine of B, and from that information, it can determine which quadrant of the circle the angle lies within. So the range of this function is from minus pi to plus pi inclusive. And here's a simple example using MATLAB, computing the arctangent of 1 divided by minus 2. It gives us the answer of 2.6779 radians, and that's an angle in the second quadrant of the circle.